How do we represent and name compounds that are made of two elements? Remember that a compound consists of two or more different kinds of atoms bonded together. In other words, two or more kinds of elements bonded together. In this movie, we just look at those which consist of two kinds of elements bonded together, not more than two. The general rule for naming these compounds is that you give the name of the element furthest on the left of the periodic table, followed by the one further to the right on the periodic table, and its ending must be -ide. Let's take some examples. In each of these examples, I'm going to show a representation of the compound in picture form, like this, and then in formula form, like this, and then give its name. So let's start with sodium chloride. Here I've got the picture of sodium chloride. It doesn't actually matter if you were to write ClNa in the picture. The picture does not have to be very exact. But when we write the formula for sodium chloride and the name for sodium chloride, then we must apply our rule. The first element that we name is the one that's further on the left of the periodic table, sodium in this case. And we write its name in full, sodium. And then after that, we write the name of the one that's further on the right of the periodic table, chlorine in this case. But instead of ending the word with -ine, we change it to -ide. So we say chloride, sodium chloride. And when we write the formula for sodium chloride, we write it in the same order. First sodium, Na, and then chloride, Cl. It's very important to write the A of sodium and the L of chlorine in lowercase, small letters, not capitals. And it's very important to write the first letter in capital. So it must be capital N, small a, capital C, small l, sodium chloride. Calcium chloride. The formula for calcium chloride is CaCl2. Notice we write Ca first and then Cl2. Why? Because calcium is further on the left than chlorine. Calcium is a metal, chlorine is a non-metal. And we find the metals on the left and the nonmetals on the right of the periodic table. Notice that the formula for calcium chloride is CaCl2, not CaCl or anything else. That means that in every molecule of calcium chloride, there are two chlorine atoms bonded to every one calcium atom. You can see that in the picture. Two chlorine, one calcium. That's why we have Ca. We could write Ca1Cl2, but we leave the one out. We just say CaCl2. The name is still calcium chloride. We could call it calcium dichloride, the di meaning that they're two chlorine for every one calcium. But it's not necessary because you only get CaCl2, nothing else. And so if we say calcium chloride, we should just automatically know that the only one it can be is CaCl2. Calcium fluoride, CaF2. Notice again, calcium is a metal, so it's on the left. Fluorine is a halogen, it's a non-metal. The specific kind of non-metal is it's a halogen, here in group 7. That's on the right. So that's why we write calcium first, then fluorine, but we change the fluorine end in into -ide, fluoride. Calcium fluoride, CaF2. Again, that little 2 means that there are two Fs for every one Ca. Magnesium chloride, MgCl2. Magnesium oxide, MgO. So in magnesium oxide, there's only one Mg for every one O, so we don't need any little numbers. Copper oxide is also like that. One copper atom bonds with one oxygen atom, so it's written as CuO with no little numbers. Again, copper being a metal is on the left. Oxygen being a non-metal is on the right. We change oxygen into oxide when we make them into a compound, copper oxide. Copper chloride, CuCl2. Hydrogen sulfide, H2S. H is on the left, S is on the right. Now, lithium hydride is a little bit of a difficult one because both lithium and hydrogen are in the same group. And so they are equally far left than the first group. And so this one you just have to remember. You must say the metal, lithium, first, followed by hydrogen, hydride. So we change the end of hydrogen into ide, and it becomes hydride, lithium hydride, LiH. So if one of the two elements is a metal, it will always be named first. So because lithium is a metal, hydrogen is not a metal. Hydrogen is a funny element. It's not a metal nor a non-metal. It kind of is both. Sometimes it behaves like a metal. Sometimes it behaves like a non-metal. We just group it in its own group. We say it's just hydrogen. It's a special kind of element. So the metal out of the two of them is lithium, not hydrogen. So we name lithium first, lithium hydride, LiH.